Doubt is why, or that was why, because it's past now. The booklet.
How secured is the Nigerian passport? And
if you are as young as I am, you know the time when we had machine readable passport in this country. Some way of you might remember. When you could get passport the same day in all the passport offices. If you have an aircraft to go, you agree with me. You could get passport in Ikoyi, you can get in Kano, you can get in Abuja, you can get anywhere. The reason was simple. We had no database. We were just writing booklets and giving Nigerians. Today, we have one central database, and that central database is linked and verified by APIS. There are three ways to do biometric of a person, not only in passport, in any technology. Fingerprint, facial, and iris, the eyes. Let me tell you, the most reliable so far is fingerprint. We started with two fingerprints, thumb and index. We realized it was being abused because officers together with criminals, they can go and put the other fingers, it will go through. Now we made it 10. That is what other biometric users, I don't want to mention their name, who are using one fingers, who are using two fingers, have not achieved. As far as Nigerian passport is concerned, I am proud to say, globally, and many developed countries have said it, it is one of the most secure documents in the world. It is one of the most secure documents in the world. The challenges it had is not in its security, it's in the process. Are you with me? The abuse of the process. And that one we have worked to cure it. Let me give you three processes we have done to solve, to make it more secure. First, we had problems of lost passport. People get multiple passport by declaring it lost. What do? You go to police station. You go and obtain an affidavit. If you come to us, sometimes even if the officers have the affidavit, they help to get things done. I'm aware. So when you get that one, you get additional passport. But the other passport is not lost though. So you had the opportunity to continue using two passports. But what did we do? We connect Interpol real time online, which I have allowed some of you to visit the database. Some of you have visited, am I correct?
Yes.
Connected with Interpol real time online, and we are the only country in Africa that are connected real time online to Interpol database of lost and stolen passport. What does it mean? It's not just a matter of saying. What does it mean? It means when today I say I've lost my passport, and a new one is issued, automatically the old one goes to the Interpol lost and we don't need to do it manually. Automatically, it goes to Interpol lost and stolen passport database, which is available at the land borders and with law enforcement. So if you cross any border with a lost and stolen passport, you are arrested. We have many cases of people who have been refused to depart because they were traveling with a lost passport. When they come, they will say, this is my passport. I say, no, you declared it lost. Look at the evidence, because we have evidence. We print the document you submitted. So you can. So the abuse has been cancelled in that area. What else do Nigerians do, again, with the help of officers to beat the system, is reissue due to exhausted pages. If you connive with an officer, you will say, look, my passport is, you know, you don't have to renew your passport just because it has expired. You can renew your passport because it has exhausted the pages. So the office, the person will connive with an immigration officer and say, look, my passport is full. I want to reissue it due to exhausted pages. No problem. We used to do it. When we do it, if the officer is criminal, he will not stamp the passport cancelled without prejudice, because it's allowed globally. For you to cancel your passport without prejudice, to continue using the visas inside the passport with a new passport. But that was not the intention. The intention of the criminal is to have two valid passports, so they will not cancel it. What did we do? Mr. President gave us approval in effect to upload into public key directorate of ICAO. There is a public key directorate in ICAO called PKD. So he has given us approval to build the infrastructure, which we are doing in the database. If you like, we can see. If you don't want to take a picture, what do we do? If you reissue your passport, That passport will not go into lost and stolen passport because it was not lost and stolen, but it will go to PKD lost passport, that key, that passport is deactivated. Are you with me? So if you travel, if you do IO, you said you are issuing your passport due to excessive pages and you got assistance from a corrupt officer, you are still in trouble. Because that passport has legally been submitted as a key, a passport that is invalid. This facility has given us ability even to cancel a passport we have issued ourselves wrongly. Somebody from another country got a passport wrongly and he has trouble. With this key, we can deactivate the passport. And the passport will not work. You present it to another country and say, this passport is no longer valid. They will refer to us, we said it was a stolen passport or it was issued wrongly. So what we are saying is that the document itself and the process has improved. It's based on technology. When we talk about passport, people look at the document itself. 80 to 90% of passport is technology. The rest is just a physical document. So I'm glad to tell you that Nigerian passport, I'm proud to say that it is one of the most secure documents in the world. And you will know also in Nigeria, if you are asked to present identity document, the most reliable identity document submitted in Nigeria is passport. Because we can know, we can verify even the fingerprint today. If you send us a fingerprint of somebody, just a fingerprint, without the person here, we can put in our certificate and find who he is. So it's the technology is perfect. Our system is secured. Don't worry about propaganda of other people. People who want to take the business away. Passport technology is being assisted by a partnership of Irish Smart Technology. It's a company, it's a Nigerian company. It's Nigerian company like any person. And I want to tell you that a company is a company. It's a person. If it is Nigerian, you hear propaganda that is from Ireland, it is from... Look, a government company is the same person as a private company. They are all citizens of Nigeria. They have the right of nationality. And they have the right to compete in an open economy. That is capitalism. So don't worry about propaganda. It is working when we are happy, things are working. But the only challenge we have, which will answer that question before I answer some of your questions, is availability of the hard copy booklet. When the passport system was established in 2003, later 2007, a competition bidding was done. This company won, the Nigerian company won, but they have failed to establish the factory in Nigeria. That's the problem they have, but they won legally. You know. So what we are saying, we are facing a time when passports were being produced. One number of passports, you get different serial number. We used to have that problem. We used to have our passport in Oluwal market. When you see our passport, it's forgery. Not that the passport has been bought. You cannot do it. So we are saying that the passport system has improved. The challenge we have is scarcity. Why is it that it has not been domesticated? Minister of Interior has been working with Minister of Justice for it to be domesticated. But what I said as an operative, you don't stop the clock because you want to do domestication. You can't disrupt operation. Some people want to disrupt operation, stop. And no, you can't. We have to continue giving service to the public while domestication continues. Some people want to stop the process and sabotage the system because they want to produce. It is not possible. The stability of production must continue. We must continue to serve Nigerians before the factory is established. Anybody can establish the factory, even immigration can. It's no longer rocket science. Passport production line is very limited with technology, which we can produce the system in, even our headquarters. That's what we want to do. A lot of difference. In 2016, we had a conference in Abeokuta where we reviewed process and document, and we brought people from airports that use our passport to tell us what were the challenges of the passport. And we look at the challenges. I'm glad to tell you that there are a lot of difference. If you take the old passport has laminate. You know, so you laminate it. When we supply passport, we supply laminate to the port places. So you can remove the laminate and do some changes. But this new passport is polycarbonate. It's sealed. You cannot work on it. You can see one difference because we saw the challenge Nigerians use. This passport has, new enhanced passport has additional 25 security features, which I will not tell you some of them. But the physical one I can tell you is polycarbonate. I can tell you that it is connected with national identity number. When we started this national identity number, people complain that it will not work. But today we have one identity. If you have a new enhanced passport, it is not possible that you have a separate bank account name. It is the same you. It is not possible for you to have BBN separately. It is the same you. Before, Nigerians have different BBN number, they have different bank account number, they have different password number. We are limiting the identity of Nigerians to one. Imagine if this country has transited to a situation where every person has one identity. We don't need to go for voter's card. You can't just register and you are with a NIN number and vote. There will be no voter's fraud. Because it is you, one person. And I'm telling you, I've seen many politicians who want to change their passport because their NIN is different. I say, no, go and change from election. Because you came with the name Babangida Mohammed. Why are you coming to me that you want to change your passport to Baba Mohammed? Yes, because you are elected as Mohammed Babangida. I'm just giving you an example. I'm not contesting. It is the dream of the minister. His dream is that immigration officers use their powers to issue passport, express, and take money. And I argued with him, but I believe with him, absolutely. Let me tell you an example. Somebody will come to me, he knows CG, please, I want to travel today. Give me passport today. I will not collect the money, but because I know him, I have given him the passport today. But you don't know me. You will not get the passport today. That itself is corruption. He has not given me money, but I have used my office to help him. It's a system. So what the minister is saying is his dream that, look, let us allow a purpose. You will not have a chance as an officer. In 6 weeks, you will get your passport. Not before, 6 weeks. But if you want to get express center, you go and pay for the express center and pay. I'm sorry to say there is no 12 express center. There is only one express center in Metaman. I've showed you in the system. One express center. So, and Mr. President approved this since we did the new enhance. When we submitted a memo for the rolling out of the new express passport, we said we need to create express center. For avoidance of doubt, I use your taxpayers' money to go to London to see how express centers are run. There is a passport express center in London. There is in every part of the world. For the elite. And Nigeria is the best place for big men. Even in airports, I say, look, they should create, you know, the big men, when they land in Nigeria, they will follow a queue in London. When they arrive in Nigeria, they want to do grab big men. I said, no problem. Create a limousine for them. Give them big welcome. Let them go to express place, but let them pay. But without compromising security, they will do clearance of passenger. They will clear their goods. The Nigerian like big people. They're big people. They like to spend. So instead of the officer to take the money, do a business partner where the private sector will benefit and government will benefit. But if you go to an immigration officer will do it for you today. You will definitely give him something for doing it quickly. But now the law says if you want to do it quickly, go to Express Center. I have seen the Express Center in London. Passport office, so we are not the one to set it. So it is not intended to corrupt system, but it's intended to fight corruption. And it's a form of transparency. You want quick services, go. If you are type of big man, you don't remember when your passport will expire because you are too busy. The day you want to travel, go to Express Center, you get pay and get it. That's what it is. Like even mobile, the future is that if you want to get passport express in a mobile, let's send a mobile to catch you, except for the sick, which we provide. So the Express Center is only one. And it's a process which the minister dreams to liberalize issues of passport. And the intention is very good, not for exploitation or corruption purposes.
Passport papers. Thank you very much.
Yes, that's why we're making reforms. It's post the look, in the olden days, before you become a passport officer, man, you pay. I'm not saying there is no official racketeering. There is, but that's what we are fighting. But we are not collecting it at the top level. We are not. You are not paying money to be a PCO. You are not paying money to get a post in this service. When the top is good, the bottom will be good. I mean it. So what we are saying is that this system we are introducing, where you don't pay to an officer, you pay online. A system where when you apply, you wait for a specified period and get your password. A system where it says you want quick service, go to express center, pay, not to an officer. I think it's towards transparency and fighting corruption. I told you, I, my humble self, I was in this office. They dropped me on the street, not with the official car, with a black ordinary car. And I put a shirt and one cap I can even get you the cup for them to see. I use that cup. I didn't put my glass because they would recognize my glass. So I passed through the place. I put face mask, difficult to recognize. And I put one kind of shirt. I entered this compound and I asked for how to get express service. And my money was requested from me, and I know who collected. I selected the officers and punished them. So leadership is about checking your people to make sure they comply. You cannot eliminate corruption, but you must check constantly. And also keep corruption distance so that it will not have opportunity. The system will remove the opportunity for corruption, and also the constant checking will stop the abuse. But the story of huge money corruption is a lot of propaganda. We have a lot of people who would want to distract. To be honest, we must be commended for trying to make things happen well. And you will see that 1st June will make things happen as quickly as possible.
Hello everyone. My name is Henrietta Agu. I report for AIT.
You know the problem we have? We have passport office issue in Nigeria, which is, I'm directly in charge in Nigeria. But I am indirectly in charge of passport issuing office in missions abroad. Johannesburg has been highlighted. You can see Johannesburg, they have 779 pending, and we can tackle this quickly. Without stopping production in Johannesburg, we'll do it. When we start, the 6 weeks time will also comply with Johannesburg. But the challenge we have discussed it in the National Assembly. We are discussing with the Minister of Foreign Affairs as some extra charges imposed by the missions. Is that the challenge? And the charges sometimes differ from New York, Atlanta, and Washington in the same country. So we are discussing with the Minister of Foreign Affairs to make sure these charges are harmonized, administrative charges, so that we don't exploit our citizens unnecessarily. So the charges you hear about lost passport are not charges going to immigration account. They are not charges going to federal government consolidated account. What happened to immigration is that all the money collected abroad in dollars for passport does not come to us to service the system. Because this passport system is a PPP system. It's a contractor finance project, which means a businessman in Nigeria borrowed money from bank and invested in what we are getting. The service that government is supposed to do, a private sector under PPP borrowed money and invested in it. Government gets tax from it, government gets share in it, and also government provides the service to citizens, which it's supposed to do. But the money for the set is the one we use to service the system. The money we get from dollars account does not even come to our account. It goes to JP Morgan Federal Consolidation account. We have written to Accountant General of Federation to leverage this to us. We cannot continue to open additional passport office abroad where the chunk of the money generated in dollars goes to JP Morgan account, doesn't go to account to service the system. And then the administrative charges are charges made by foreign missions, which doesn't come to us as a service. We have staffs there. We pay them from our salary. They don't collect that money. But we are discussing with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs to make sure these resources are minimized without hardship to Nigerians, are also harmonized, are also paid as a single fee. Because the problem, you cannot go to supermarket and pay fees differently. I've argued that in the National Assembly and to my colleagues. You can imagine you go to supermarket to buy a bag of rice, and they tell you the packaging is 2 naira, go and pay it in that area. The rice is 30,000 naira, pay in this place. How inconvenient will it be? It has to be one fee. It is the responsibility of the supermarket owner to separate his salary and other things. That's what we want the missions to be run. One of the dreams we have in the missions we are working is to remove passport issuance from missions. We have achieved this in visa. And if you look at visas issued to Nigerians in Nigeria, in some countries, you don't go to the embassy to get the visa. You go to a third party to get the visa. We want to remove passport issuance in the missions so that it will go to a center for many reasons. First, security. A lot of Nigerians can riot, can break things if things are not done the way they want it, or even when they are told to wait and follow the process because they know it is a Nigerian mission. But if it is a private sector in the middle of London, like McDonald's shop, like chicken fries shop, they will follow the rule of London. They will follow the appointment time. That is, we want to remove missions from having direct contact of passport issue. We are already working. We have sent the business model to government. Due process will be followed. If we do that, there will be no problem. It will be on appointment. You will come, you wait for the period, you get your passport. If you misbehave, the police will arrest you because you are in a territory, not in the diplomatic side of it. Even missions have no space anymore. Check London, for example, which is the highest volume of passport issuance in the world for us. Northumberland Avenue is a very small place. It's a very business district. Like, you don't have place to park. You don't have place to queue. So if we give it to a private sector, I think this is going to work. Nigerians are happy to do that. We are exploring the possibility of reissuing without physically being present. We have been tasked to think of how do you reissue your passport without being physically being present. It's an issue we have been discussing and we are working on this. So it's an issue which we are committed to doing. It will be 6 weeks waiting time, and we are committed to comply to this. But the system is like the way I saw it, even in London. Even when you issue fast track, you go to fast track for 24 hours, you submit your document, you left, and they found out there is something document, they send you a message, you come and rectify it, then 24 hours start when you rectify. That's how things would work. So the 6 weeks also will be like that. If there is a problem, you submit your name for passport. Your name is Mohammed Babandede, but your NIN number said Mohammed Babandede. The system will not go. We'll send you a text to rectify from NIMC, because we are not NIMC. When you rectify, the sign start from there. So what is important is communication. When you communicate with the applicant, you get reply. That's how this works. Nothing will change. The price will remain the same June. There will be no increase of price of passport as it is on the website. In short, we have cut off any extra charges. It will be as it is on the website. So there will be no extra increase on the price. Minister has not increased. The powers is with him. He has not increased. You ask for the total. These are the total. This is total for January to add to backlog. The total backlog, I think this is for enhanced. No, foreign. This is foreign. Foreign. This is foreign. The grand total is going to be 17,000, isn't it? That's then for local. Local is 71,000. Okay. For local enhanced, 46,000. As of yesterday. These are the actual backlog available in figures.
There are allegations that